Chintanyi gets us underway here.
Love one.
And while Mima Ito takes the first point here, you're not going to see too many points with her that far behind the table. It's not how she's going to win. It's not her tactics. I'll tell you more about Mima Ito in a moment.
Two love.
Yeah, Chen got through by beating Chen Suyu, who we saw in the doubles earlier, women's doubles. She won that in straight games fairly comfortably. Mima Ito, we saw in action against Lily Tao on the opening day.
Yeah, it was a 3-1 victory. Mm. It was quite exciting, actually. For those of you just joining us, Mima Ito uses short pips for that Mima punch on the backhand side. It's a fast, flat shot, and she can do the same with her forehand. Oh, it's a
one
rocket.
Three.
Really nice from her backhand there.
And her service game is so dangerous. Yeah. Very few players can receive in a way to shut down that shot. It's the Bruce Lee punch. It's 1 inch. She recoils and recovers so quickly.
Yeah, the service game was really strong, wasn't it, against Lily the other day?
It always is. It's one of her, I'd say, strongest weapons. And she knows this because she's got a bullet waiting. Look how short that stroke was for the forehand. Just a quick slap. It's like when you get your thumb pricked, hits it and pulls back.
Four, two.
Yep, starting well here, Mima Ito.
Man, loving the music, just thinking about over the years what Mima Ito has been through. She's obviously had tons to celebrate, one of the most celebrated players in the game, but has had some heartbreak moments as well that have cost her quite a lot. I think she's still working through.
5-2.
Yeah, this is a person who's had some good success as well. Olympic gold in mixed doubles. Got a silver in the team event. Those were both in her home games. Bronze in Rio as well, the team.
3-5.
The Olympic gold is a nice little token to have there.
Mm.
Times like this, maybe a service gift, a little omiyage, a souvenir for Chen Tianyi. Now have three.
4-5.
Yeah, excellent work, Chen Tianyi.
Very smart play. Stretch her out wide to the forehand in a way where she can't rip it so that you can go deep to the backhand corner. Mima Ito isn't blessed in length of step.
6-4.
Yes, she's 1-5-2, or straight 5 foot, Mima Ito.
Oh, yeah. I remember those 2 centimeters. Her mom reminded me of it in an airport a long time ago when she was still growing. Or maybe
7-4.
I should say when she had just gotten there, when she would stop growing, maybe. Side spin begins, and Mima Ito, no problem. More side spin than almost anyone in the game, especially over the table. Chen Tianyi with that banana flick, and then the chop block from Mima Ito.
4-8.
Excellent work. 4 points now, the lead for Ito.
I've been watching Mima-chan play for quite some time, and that forehand looks even more different than usual. Take a look at how she slaps. Get ready. Deep push, just quick slap, but she's right there and ready. The arm never extends far from her, which is funny because, again, she doesn't have a lot of wingspan to begin with. Service warning here.
Make sure you toss the ball above the table. 4-8.
Just to clarify, meaning above the height of the table, you can't actually break the back wall or toss the ball or hit the ball from inside or over the table. Just above the height, must be.
4-9.
Ito extends that lead to 5.
Just drying the ball there on the shirt to make sure that it's got full traction and grip for play.
9-5.
Gonna throw this back. It's a long way for continue, but we know the Chinese players. start to exert the pressure in these sort of stages of games.
Yeah, that was a very impressive recovery from a few big shots coming in deep to the corner. Ito still very focused here. Serves back on her side.
9-6.
Look at points now for Chen Tianyi.
It's a smart, I'd say, combination of things to play. Stay in position on the wide forehand. Bait Mima Ito into trying to play a flat shot on the short side of the table with the pips. It's going to be tough.
6.
Wait for the shot there. Ito now has 4 game points. Very happy with herself.
And
she takes the first game, Ito.
And remind you how unpredictable she can be.
1 love.
Directly off the serve. To emphasize our point on how good she is on them.
2.
That's another really good point, isn't it, for her?
When it's the backhand, it's a Mima punch. When it's the forehand, it's a Mima smash, and it is tough to get back. The serve, as you said, excellent to set up just enough height for that third ball to be a finisher.
One, two.
Yeah, the net playing a big part in that one.
Yeah, typically the players will try to avoid that. Get ready for a strawberry there. Very short stroke. She just has explosive energy, Mima Ito. It's unlike anyone else in the game. Yang Xiaoxin, somewhat of a similar setup, but still the speed and energy that we see from Mima Ito, the stance too. You'd think maybe she'd need her feet to be wider because she's small, but keeps them close.
3-2.
Part of that might just be vision. I mean, if you get too low at her height, seeing over the net is going to be a little bit tricky, but it's a fine balance to be in position.
3-0.
Good points there for Mima Ito. This record doesn't really change too much when playing left-handers like our opponent tonight.
4-0.
Just gesturing to herself what she probably wanted to do.
So I was able to access their head-to-head, and the last three times they played, Mima Ito has won fairly convincingly. Twice in 2019, last time 4-0.
4-5.
But I think Chen Tianyi 2019, Chen Tianyi 4 years later, which is today, it's a big deal, big difference.
5-0.
She's in a better place now than in the second game, which perhaps wasn't the first. That last time in the Austrian Open, November of 2019.
6-5.
Good rally, that one.
It's always fascinating to me to see a contrast of position with styles. Mima Ito behind the table. I mean, it's just completely diffusing her threat and her game. And she still almost counters with that punch from way back.
Hard to counter that.
6-0.
Draws level.
I feel like Mima Ito is the litmus test for the Chinese women. banana split there. That's like the banana flick, except you put underspin instead of topspin on it. Nima Ito will vary that up with straight side spin, sometimes a bit of underspin just to keep it confusing.
6-7.
We talk, Adam, about records against Chinese players whenever we have one of these sort of matchups. Nima Ito, one of the more successful ones. It's still 30 out of 81.
6-7.
30 wins out of 81.
Wow.
That's 37%.
It's impressive. But the point is made. It's less than 50.
8-6.
I think we found our only one. Earlier, we had someone. Is it Eugene Wang?
Yeah.
6 of 11.
It was 55 before today. So it's now
dead
6
even.
And 12. Yeah.
8-7.
Omiyage. That means souvenir. In Japanese. Ooh, look at that. Look. I like it. Processing. 8-0. And processed.
Yeah. That draws a level. So you felt that 37% is. Were you surprised that it was 37 or that was still quite impressive? As in, you thought it might be higher?
Given no.
Okay.
I thought it would be lower.
Right.
9-8.
And still regarded as probably the greatest threat to a Chinese player.
Basically her nickname.
Yeah.
I think the reason is the televised matches, the ones we see, are against the biggest players.
Right.
I mean, even if you go down to Chun Xingtong, who's one of the top 8 seeds here, Chun Xingtong is, I think, 5-1 against Mima Chan.
8-10.
So she's got 2 game points here, Mima Ito.
The reason I bring that up is what we see on TV are the matches against the biggest stars of Team China. We don't see the early rounds, the round of 32 necessarily, against someone who's third string from China. Those wins add up, so 37% makes sense.
9-10.
Saves one, that's it.
Good play there to the short side. Bit of surprise factor, leaving that ground to be covered by Mima Ito.
10.
And she does it, draws level.
I was impressed that she could withstand that Mima smash. You'll see it here. Fast, held her ground, just had to jump for a moment to get her feet replanted. Return the ball. Not an easy day at work here in game 2.
That means now 2 clear points to win this game.
11.
It's Jen who's got the game point.
There's one point that I don't think in my lifetime I will forget involving Mima Ito, and I don't think she will either. It was Wang Yidi at T2. The final point, the golden point, to decide who got $100,000, and it was a similar shot to that.
10.
That's a lovely way to bring up the second game.
And that's what cracked open the record for Sunying Sha. Before that, they were fairly even, and I feel like that was sort of the tipping point in the flavor of their relationship on opposing sides of the table. I feel like for Team China, if you're going to be regularly representing China, you're going to be trusted in the biggest events, you have to show that you can beat Mima Ito.
Right.
And it's a stepping stone. It really is. There's not a higher step in terms of foreigners to beat. Chen Tianyi isn't there yet. She hasn't been before today. Mm-hmm. Last 3 encounters, if she can do it today, and she can show that it's not a coincidence, she's got bright things ahead.
1-2.
That's another glorious forehand down the line for Chen.
Perfect placement on the move as well. Great court awareness, peripheral vision of the opponent.
2-0.
Just going back to, again, very good on the serve that Mima Ito. You know, she'll have seen what had happened earlier today thinking to herself, that's two less people I got to worry about. With those Chinese players out of the reckoning.
Oh, you were talking about Mima Ito.
Mima Ito.
That's so funny. From the start of that sentence, I thought you were talking about Chen Tianyi. But both of these players could be affected by that.
Well,
I think.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it applies to either one of them, right? But Mima Ito being a seed herself, that's your chances.
So how do you think that might affect her mentally out here?
Actually, the flip side of that is we've seen a lot of the more fancied opponents today lose as well. Chen Tianyu also might be taking that on board and thinking, hey, that can happen for the others, why not me?
That was an incredibly unpredictable conversation. It just goes to show you subjectivity. Right? Who knows what someone's thinking? You could be thinking anything out here.
Absolutely.
There's so many different perspectives and reads on any result, any situation. Both times I had different thoughts. I had predicted the finish of your sentence to be different. Fascinating.
4-0.
Like you said, anything could happen. But it's been one of those days where pretty much anything can happen.
So I thought what you were going to say was that Mima Ito was going to think, oh, it's an open field. I should have an easier time, less competition. Yeah. Then I thought you were going to say Chen Tianyi would feel that she's carrying more weight now. And all that's possible, too.
I actually meant the former. Maybe that didn't come across. But yes, you are correct about the latter as well. Chen now opens up a two-point lead.
This is going to be tough. Again, this is why pros practice not thinking about the score. Because Mima Ito had her share of opportunities in game number two. Now she's looking at being behind in the match.
4-7.
And again, that would be another seed on the women's side. Mima Ito, the top non-Chinese player here at the Singapore Smash and therefore in the world.
7-5.
Yeah, there's both Wang Yidi.
And Chen Meng.
Chen Meng. We're in her half of the draw.
Ooh.
So big. But hey, let's not get ahead of ourselves, because right now it's Chen who's leading here.
That's what makes it so exciting to watch. This could be yet another Newsline story. Newsworthy headlining, even.
Excellent rallies between these two.
They've changed quite a lot. I felt like Mima Ito from the start was very much in control, but here she's having to be more responsive, move, cover the corners. The rallies are getting longer as the match does.
Seven, eight.
Just some delicate shots played there. Really lovely.
Perfect description. I mean, she took all the pace off it. Mima Ito, very soft hands. Right there, slowed it way down. Nearly got a second bounce on the table, which would have ended the point outright in the favor of Mima Ito.
Eight all.
Puff for the cheeks. It's a tough mission out here today.
Is that three in a row now? Either way, that last one off the hand didn't miss by much. It'd be interesting. When we have the replay system here, it's got to be between the wrist and the fingertips. Tough to see exactly where that ball hit on the hand.
9-8.
Tipping the nets to her frustration. A couple of game points for Chen.
Good look at that. The serve drifting just long, but the placement right. I saw the ball kid and thought it was a famous teammate. That's really funny. Got some young looking players on the Chinese national team. The Dark Knight.
11-8, game 2.
She has taken game 2, Chen.
Love 1.
Acknowledgement there from Chen.
Yeah, a little bit of fortune going her way. Yima Chan looking for that tomahawk to go around the net or something low. Just leave some awkward ball on the table to follow up.
1-0.
Ito has to win this to stay in the match, this game. She's got a task ahead of her against Chen, who's playing shots like that.
She's just becoming a sniper. Chen Tianyi's getting much more clear on where the opening is. She's taking her chances. These parallels and moments of a little bit of movement, a shift of weight on the other side, and that's enough.
1-3.
It's not really working out for her at the moment, Ito.
Come out.
That is why we have a timeout.
Back from the timeout here, Yima Chan down.
4-2.
Yeah, she needs. She needs to go away now. It's been a tough fourth game so far for her.
I mean, this would be a very early exit. The draw's not easy, of course. Mm. But expectations are high here.
4-3.
As we said, in half the draw. Some big names have gone.
I still can't believe she can hold the racket so delicately and still not lose grip of it for that banana split there.
Three, five.
That net completely breaking the rhythm. But still, effort pays off. Chen Tianyi saving it for one more shot. And it wasn't a passive shot. Mm. She really did everything she could to reach across the body and send it back with some pace on it.
4-5.
Better from Ito.
Did you see the look of Mima Ito? Right after the shot, there was a stare as if to say, did you feel that?
More of that right now.
6-4.
Much like Ma Lin Shuhui, not only a pen holder, but a passionate coach, making his voice quite clearly heard, reminding Chen Tianyi that she's got support behind her.
6-5.
That edge. Barest of acknowledgements.
5-7.
She's not able to put on a run at the moment, Mima Ito.
Yeah, Chen Tianyi is doing an excellent job of playing every single point with clear determination. She doesn't seem to lose focus or be distracted. She seems well prepared, ready to move, and staying aggressive.
With that.
Very smart placement there with the Mima punch down the line. Smothers the ball on the uprise. Opening there, comes back. Ball hadn't even reached its peak. There have been calculations about Mima Ito's reaction time. Fastest in the game.
7-0.
She's finally drawn level here in this fourth game. She surge ahead. Take us to a fifth.
Seven, eight.
Might be the first time she's had the lead in this fourth game. Hard to think about this one.
Eight,
nine. Chin, who comes out on top?
Surprise factor high on this one. The parallel in the rally. Ito gets low on this one, plays a low spinny forehand. And I think she thought the table didn't reach that far. It's frustrating because, you know, how much time does she spend working with this table? 5 by 9 feet. It's the same size no matter how small it looks, at least at
nine
the professional old. Level.
This is a very, very tense moment now. Mima Ito.
I think most table tennis players can relate to that feeling. It's frustrating when you thought it was off and it came down and you didn't try.
Nine,
take that. Mima Ito sets up game point.
Your reaction was pretty much perfect for, I'm sure, how we all felt about that. Smacked it from behind the table. A shocking shot. High risk, high reward, and game point now for Mima Ito.
What a time to do it. Mima Ito takes that game. I've seen an upset on this table. Infinity Arena.
Love one.
And to be clear, the upset would be Chien winning this. If you're not so familiar with table tennis and see a Chinese name there and think, well, she must be the favorite. Well, not in this one. I don't know. It just feels like suddenly she's decided, I'm just going to play these sort of shots.
That shot just sent me back to my childhood. 21.1 gigawatts behind that shot.
I think she's played that now, what, three times in the last 5 points?
Two, one.
I'm impressed that she's been able to win so many points from as far behind the table as she is. For most players, this is not far. It's comfort zone. It is no Mima land. She's mostly on the passive receiving reactionary sort of spot there, a little more defensive, but it's going to be tough with those flat shots from that far back.
And as we've seen with most of the five gamers so far, fifth one, very, very tense, and it's pressing point. Trading points between the two. See how this one pans out.
Three, two.
Continues won the last two.
And the way it's happened, you can understand the body language of Mima Ito.
Three, all.
At the towel break here, I just wanted to tell you, you were right. For those of you at home, we have a lot of fun conversations in the commentary booth sometimes between games. Liang Jingquan and Lin Gao Yuan, that was the last time we saw Liang Jingquan because of the celebration.
Yeah, towards the end of last year.
Right. After that, there was a little time out, so to speak. Go to your room.
Three, four.
Have some alone time. And he's come back. Looking pretty good so far in 2023, right?
Yeah, champion in Goa last week.
Making up for lost time. Making a point. to that far corner. Four all.
Been a lot of solid defense from Mima Ito, the way she's able to add that side spin as she covers the wide wing and bring back something awkward. She's got all sorts of answers. But so does Chen Tianyi. I mean, she's incredibly well prepared, athletic, strong on both wings. Whoever wins this next point has the momentum when they switch sides.
4-5.
Mima Ito takes a slender lead across to the other side.
Just skimming the top of the net on the shot, too. Didn't see much, though, in terms of, again, it could be a thing of the past. We'll see. The heat of the moment, I think even in 2019 with Liu Shiwen, there were a lot of moments where we saw certain behavioral changes.
Five all.
Slumping the shoulders. Ito, reaction to that point.
Two reasons for it for me. One, the serve was odd from that camera angle. It felt like it sat up a little bit inside. Two, the next ball, that's normally breakfast, lunch, and dinner for Mima Ito. Meaning she makes it most of the time.
Couple of points here for Chen.
Six all.
This one is so tight, isn't it?
That push was as off the bounce as can be. Watch this in replay. Watch Mima's timing. Right off the bounce. Leaves it there so that there's no attack on the other side. That was a gutsy push. Push when you play an underspin shot from inside the table. She hits it before it bounces. She loses the point. So very gutsy.
7-6.
Just to say, though, that is incredibly rare. Sorry, you were going to say about Chen, though?
I was going to say, Chen just in front. It's so, so finely balanced.
A calm in the face like Coach Matsuzaki.
Seven all.
Really battling each and every point.
In these replays, it's crazy to see how fast the ball is just whizzing back and forth across the net. A lot of decisions to be made here. Many serves possible, but a lot of strong receives waiting.
7-8.
That return from Chen. Mima Ito. Not long.
It's tough. I mean, she wears her heart on her sleeve, but the receive that she got here, it's not bad, but this is her game. This is what she feeds on.
8-0.
Following the pattern. No one able to take more than a 1-point lead at the moment.
Also interesting, Mima Ito decided to go passive on the third ball. A little bit of height on it. Changed it up, though, after missing a few attacks, and it worked out in her favor.
Excellent work from Ito.
The pattern here, changing it up, going twice to that backhand quickly. Quite surprising. It'll be fun to watch in the replay. One middle. And then right back to where it came from, behind the shift of the weight.
Ito has set up two match points. We've seen two other matches get to 10 all, by the way, in the fifth.
It's not over yet, but I can already feel the amount of stress for Chen Tianyi and for Xu Hui. I feel like the Chinese coaches are very much in the battlefield. Uh-oh. And here's the timeout. Wow.
Took a while.
One
point saved. Chen Tianyi lives to see another point at least.
I'm sure many viewers in the stadium and around the world have their hands on the back of their head when she just reels back to smash like that. If that ball's in, it's tough to get back. That could be the match.
Got it to 10-all. The amused look on Ito's face. And playing it in her mind as well.
This is how tough a day is as a professional player against one of the representatives of Team China, the biggest stage. Alternating serves from here on out, it's Chen Tianyi with the serve.
Yeah, points needed to win.
10-11.
Chen Tianyi has turned this around. She now has a match point.
That's three in a row here, despite a few attempts from Mima Ito.
Yeah.
Could feel a little shift after that forehand smash missed. Opportunity to pass the biggest test for Team China.
Chen Tianyi continues what has been a superb day.